The birds will get their destination one day. The spread speak on them. His father had started feeling this in his childhood. His son has the wisdom and foresight to do something big. But no one knew what the big task would be and how big it would be. The person who traveled from cycle parts business to Bharti Airtel for just 20,000 rupees and that too on loan, Mr. Sunil Bharti Mittal, a personality such a person who thinks out of the box and thinks much before others and thought his hard work, dedication and ability, but not only in his own country but also in foreign countries. He made his own identity, who provided employment opportunities to thousands of families to live with dignity. So let's see a small moment in the life journey of the hero of our today's story, Mr. Sunil Bharti Mittal. Friends, today I am going to talk Indian industrialist, socialist and one of the world's largest telecom companies, Sunil Mittal, chairman of Airtel. He is considered one of the most successful people in the world. Sunil's company Airtel is India's first world third largest telecom company, and currently it is operating in about 18 countries with the number of customers estimated at 372 million. At present, Sunil Mittal is the 8th richest person in India. Friends, Sunil did not get this success just like that. This is the fruit of his hard work, true dedication and efforts. So friends, without taking much of your time, we know the life story of Sunil Mittal, founder and chairman of the enterprises from the beginning. Sunil was born on 23rd October 1957 in Ludhiana, Punjab. Father name was Satpal Mittal, who was a politician and had also been a member of parliament twice, from the Lok Sabha and once from the Rajya Sabha. Although Vera has left this world, he died in 1992 due to a heart attack.
Taking about education, what Sunil Mittal does, he did earlier study from Winburg Alien School in Mussoorie and Sindhia School in Gwalior, and later in 1975 he completed his graduation in Bachelor of Arts and Science from Punjab University. Although Sunil says that from the very beginning he had no particular interest in studies, and from childhood I wanted to start my own business. That is why at the age of just 18 he took his first step towards business and then took 20,000 from his father and started making a part of the cycle with some friends. He realized after making some motorcycle parts, in the meantime, he could not be very successful by giving his time, so he decided to stop it. That's why he decided to call it off and still move to Mumbai, where in 1981 he had an import license and then started selling portable generators exported from Japan. In the meantime, they will benefit greatly. It looked like it was all safe. But then the Indian government banned the import of generators because two Indian companies were given license to manufacture generators in their own country. Although Sunil Mittal did not give up on this incident, but learned that if any such opportunities comes in the future, he will definitely take advantage of it. Even further, Sunil also continued to do different things, and in 1984, from Taiwan's company Kingel, he started importing and selling that new generation of button phones, because till now the same old ones were being used in India. In this, the number had to be rotated by pressing and holding. In 1990s, Sunil also sold fax machines and wireless phones. What happened after that changed Sunil Mittal's whole life. In 1992, they are being auctioned in India, bid for the license of mobile phone networks, and his company BPL also got one license among the four companies. However, he had to face many problems here as well. The government had put a condition for license that they must have some experience as a telecom operator. That's why Mittal tied up with a French telecom company away this problem. From here, Sunil Mittal and his company never looked back, and with the Airtel brand name, they crossed the 2 lakhs mobile subscriber market in few years and become the first telecom company to do so. But as of now, the number of Airtel customer in 372 million. Sunil Mittal's contribution in 2007 made him India's third highest, was awarded the civil honor Padma Shri. Sunil Mittal is a businessman as well as works as a social worker. Bharti Foundation runs a trust which provides quality education, books and uniforms to poor children of the village. An inspiration to all of us. He failed many times in his life and kept on recovering, but he never gave up, trying to do something big, and says, "Don't give up or else." To efforts is not a vain, those who try never give up.